Measurement Unit, Section 4, Converting Between Measurement Systems. This next topic that we cover is switching back and forth between the English and the metric measurements. To do these conversions, you'll need to refer to a table of conversion factors and use the conversion factor fraction method. This first example asks us to convert 20 ounces into grams. If we refer to the table at the back of our book, or a standard conversion table, we're going to go fishing in that third column, which is English and metric conversion or equivalent values. And as we look under the category of mass and weight, we find a relationship between ounces and grams. So to do our conversion, we'll take the given measurement, express it as a fraction with a denominator of 1. We will take that relationship between ounces and grams in putting it in a conversion factor fraction such that the ounces are going to cancel out. So the actual value is 1 ounce is equal to 28.3 grams. When we simplify our fraction, we'll cancel out common factors in the numerator and the denominator, leaving us to multiply the fraction, which is multiplying the numerator, and the denominator, which is 1, not affecting our value. So the equivalent of 20 ounces turns out to be 566 grams. The next problem asks us to convert 3.4 kilograms to ounces. Again, we look at our conversion table, the third column. We're looking for kilograms and ounces under the mass and weight category that's there. We take the given measurement, we express it as a fraction with a denominator of 1, but we run into a little bit of a problem in this one. There is no direct way to go from kilograms to ounces. That means the problem will require more than one conversion factor, and here's what it'll look like. When we look in the table, we're looking for a value that's going to cancel out our kilograms, the given unit of measurement. And we see from the table that 1 pound is equivalent to 454 thousandths of a kilogram. Placing that kilogram value in the denominator, it's equivalent in the numerator. We essentially are multiplying by 1. That allows our kilograms to cancel out. And before we do any calculation, we're not quite done. We need to now find something that converts our current measurement, which is in pounds, into the desired unit of measurement of ounces. So now we switch over to the English side of the table. And when we put our conversion factor together, we want to be sure that we have pounds in the denominator so it cancels out our current pound measurement. When we look under weight on the English side, since pounds is English and we're headed to ounces, which is also English, we find 1 pound is equal to 16 ounces. Here's our second conversion factor fraction. Pounds cancel out, and now we're ready to do the simplification. Multiplying fractions, you multiply your numerators together, multiply all denominators together, and the last step then would be to take that numerator product and divide it by the denominator product, resulting in 119.8 ounces, the equivalent of the 3 4/10 kilograms. In this next example, we have 120 kilometers per hour and looking for an equivalent mile per hour. To do that, we're talking about a rate here. And the rate that we're talking about is a distance per unit of time. The time in both of these problems or factors is hours, so we're okay there, no conversion necessary, but the numerator, the distance, is kilometers, and we need to express it in an equivalent mile per hour. So we start with the given value, 120 kilometers per 1 hour. We're looking on our conversion table for a relationship between kilometers and miles on that third column, which has the equivalent values in the English and metric system, we look under length. When we set up that conversion factor fraction, we want to make sure that the kilometer is in the denominator so that it will cancel out our current kilometers. From the table, we find that 1 mile is equal to 1.61 kilometers. Placing them in the correct place or order allows us to cancel out kilometers. Unit-wise, if we just look at this, we have a mile per hour. That's a pretty good indication that we have it set up correctly. Simplifying the fraction by multiplying numerator values and multiplying denominator values and then doing the division, it turns out that 74 and 5 tenths mile per hour is equivalent to the 120 kilometer per hour given speed. For additional practice, you have problems on page 24 and 25 on your textbook.